Good morning everyone. Yesterday we had started the chapter fiber to fabric, and yesterday we were discussing the topic fibers. Now today we will continue that. I told you fibers are thin strands of thread that are further made up of still thinner strands. Fibers are of two types, natural and synthetic. Natural fibers are the fibers that are obtained from the nature, either from plant or from animal. Then we had started the topic wool. Wool is a natural fiber that we obtain from animals. Now, our next topic for today is wool yielding animals. Means we have to study about the animals that give us wool. No doubt in the market, sheep's wool is most common, but still there are some other animals that also give us wool. For example, goat, yak, camel. Although sheep's wool is most common in the market, still these wool are also there. Suppose for goat, there is a goat named Angora goat. Angora goat is a goat that gives us wool, and the name of that wool is Angora wool. So Angora goat gives us Angora wool. Now there is one more type of goat, that is Kashmiri goat. Kashmiri goat, this goat gives us wool, and it gives us fine quality wool, and that wool is used to make pashmina shawl. You must be aware of the pashmina shawls. They are easily available in the market. These pashmina shawls are obtained from the wool which is obtained from the Kashmiri goat. Now next is yak. Yak also provides us wool, and that wool and yak wool, it is most common in Tibet and Ladakh. Yak's wool is mostly common in Tibet and Ladakh. Now camel. Not all the camel they give us wool. There are special varieties, special breeds of camel that provide us wool. One is llama and second is alpaca. These are two varieties of camel that provide us wool. Now, what do you understand by the term variety or breed? Like most common example I am giving you, in case of dog, you had seen there is Pomeranian, there is Pug, there is Bulldog. These are different breeds of dog. In the same way, there are different breeds of camel like alpaca, llama and many more. There are different breeds of sheep, and yes, different breeds of sheep, or you can say different varieties of sheep, they give us different type of wool. You can see in the market the different type of wools are available, and they are of different prices. Why? Because the wool are obtained from the sheep, and there are so many breeds of sheep. If the sheep breed is having soft hair, then the quality of wool will be good and its price will be high. Clear? Now, our next topic is breeding and rearing of sheep. Now, our next topic is rearing. Now, first of all, what do you understand by the term rearing? Rearing means to take care. Suppose while studying this topic, we are just talking about sheep, yak, goat. So rearing of sheep means taking care of sheep. Rearing basically means taking care of animals by providing them food, proper medical facilities, proper healthcare facilities, proper sanitation facilities, a place to live in, proper shelter, you can say. So rearing means to take care of the animals. Rearing means to take care of animals by providing them proper facilities, proper food, proper medical facilities, proper sanitation facilities, proper living facilities. Like rearing of sheep means taking care of sheep by giving them proper food, medicines and everything that they require. Now if I talk about sheep, what is their food? three varieties. There are three types of animals: herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. Herbivores are the animals that feed on grass, or you can say plant and plant products. Carnivores, they feed on the flesh of other animals, and omnivores, they eat both plant as well as flesh. So if I talk about sheep, sheep is herbivores. It means sheep feeds on plant or plant products. Like the most commonly food of the sheep is grass, leaf, jawar, wheat, pulses, minerals, plus oil cakes. Oil cakes, these are the leftover material, residue you can say, which are left after taking out the oil from the seeds. You know, there are some seeds like groundnut seeds, we can take out the groundnut oil. So after taking out the groundnut oil from the groundnut seeds, the leftover material is called as oil cakes. Oil cakes are also a food of sheep. So first step is rearing of sheep or any other animal. Clear? Thank you.